Hi, you guys! It's me, Mandy, and I'm back. And I know you guys are so happy about it. But I am back because I have something that I have had, seriously, so many people request this. This is my client, Marianne. She's adorable. Love her to death. And she is just super cute. But she is doing something very drastic today, and we're totally transforming her hair. So I want to show you guys. As you can see, this is blonde, beautiful hair. She's been blonde for about a year. What we're doing today is creating her to have more low maintenance, more low key hair. Because we're both moms, and she's a mom of almost five, right?
Four.
Oh, almost four.
Yes.
She's having a baby soon, guys. And she's like, I'm a mom. I don't have time to do my hair. I don't have time to get my hair colored every 6 weeks. Like, this is crazy. So, I want to show you guys really quick. Put your head down for me. If you see her regrowth, she has a pretty harsh line, which is annoying for a lot of people. But for her especially, because it's pretty harsh. She loves being blonde, but she's ready for a change. So if you can see this, she's actually a natural strawberry blonde hair. She actually is a redhead, you guys. So guess what we're doing? We're taking her back to red. We're taking her back to her natural color. She's gonna love it, she's gonna look beautiful. Her skin tone is gonna be amazing. And it's gonna pop out her features. So I'm gonna show you guys the process of how I'm gonna be doing it, what colors I'm using, and how to take a blonde to red, because it's not as easy as you think. It's not like, oh, hey, why don't we just go ahead and mix these colors and put it on your hair and slap it on. No, there's technique to it. So I want you guys to learn how to do this if this is what you're looking for. So you guys stay there. I'm gonna show you the color line and the colors I'm using and the techniques that I'll be using. All right, you guys, so I'm gonna be using Redken Color Gels because it's my all-time favorite. I'm gonna be using, the main focus is gonna be between a 7 level. So I'm gonna be mixing 6 and 8 together and creating more of like a 7 level. But the base color that I really wanna focus on is this 8WG. Redken Color Gels is absolutely amazing. So I'm gonna show you guys really quick how I'm mixing this. I'm gonna be using 6RO, which is Bonfire, which sounds scary, but this is gonna give me the option to have the redness of the hair that I want pop. I'm gonna do a little bit of this. So I'm gonna do 6RO about that much. Okay, that's about right. Then I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna mix in all three of these colors. Now I'm gonna go in here and do 6WG. It's called Mango, which is beautiful. I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna do actually a little bit more, probably half the bottle, obviously depending on how thick the hair is. Now I'm gonna go in here and do 8WG. I really want a lot of this in here because this is the main color I want, and she has a ton of hair. So I'm gonna go in here and I'm pretty much gonna do, I pretty much have the entire bottle in there. I'm about right to there, so I have pretty much the entire bottle in there. Now what's gonna happen is I'm gonna go in here and I'm going to use Redken Color Gels Developer 10 volume because I'm depositing only. So I'm going to go in here and I'm going to mix my mixture up. That's about right. And now on the other side, I'm going to go in here and I'm going to be doing a heavy foil. So I'm going to be going in here and leaving out some peekaboo colors of some warmer tones. It's not all going to be red. So I'm gonna actually go in here and I'm gonna weave out the color. I'm gonna put in here some conditioner so I can weave out and not have that blonde color stain to red, because I definitely wanna keep those blondes because I'm gonna tone. At the end, I'm gonna be toning and you'll see me do all that. So I'm now gonna mix this all up together and I'm gonna get it to the consistency that I want it to be. And the reason why there's so much in here, you guys, is because my client, Marianne, has a ton of hair. This is like the good consistency that I like it to be. And then on this side, you can see it's just conditioner. So now I'm going to show you guys my technique of how I'm going to be doing this. I want to show you the inspirational picture. If you can see this hair right here, it is strawberry, like a strawberry warmth red blonde, whatever you want to call it, but it's a redhead. So we have some really pretty pops of tones in here. Do you want to learn the technique of how to apply red hair onto blonde? You stay there. I'm going to take up this section, okay? And I actually want these to be a little bit more chunkier. So when I go in here and weave, medium kind of larger pieces. This is going to stick. This is going to be at the end of the day when I go in and I tone it. It's going to be more warm. It's not going to be blonde. So right now, I'm just going to go in here and I'm going to apply on just my conditioner. That the reason why I'm doing conditioner is because I don't want any redness or anything to touch when I actually put in the red all over. So the pieces that I want to have kind of be the pop and the dimension and the contrast, I'm just going to go in here and apply conditioner, and I'm going to give it a good saturated conditioning because I want it to be filmy. The minute any color touches that, if it was blonde, it would take it in just a second. That's why I'm going in here and putting heavy amounts of conditioner in here. And I'm going to foil this. And I'm going to do the pieces that I want to have kept left out. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the back side. And I'm going to foil, I'm going to paint this completely all over her hair. And now I don't have to worry about the underneath this foil at all. Because I have conditioner on it. It's not gonna, if it bleeds into the foil, the conditioner will just keep that color from staying off of it. Does that make sense, guys? Does that make sense? I hope it does, because I'm being very clear. Okay, I'm gonna do this throughout the entire hair. Saturating this like really good. A, because she has super coarse hair, and coarse hair just takes a little bit of more color and more product to work in. So it's going to be super saturated right in here. Really what this is all coming down to, you guys, is yeah, the technique and the way you weave is important, but if you're taking a blonde red, you want to make sure it's that perfect tone of red. It can turn out to be more orange than red, or it can turn out to be more red than orange. So really the technique of this all comes down to making sure you have the right tone, the right level of color that you want to use on the hair, and making sure that you're honestly mixing color. Add in more colors to pop out dimension and contrast. So I'm going to just do this all the way throughout the entire hair. And I can't wait for you guys to see this after. Can I just mention one thing while I'm doing this? I'm just sidetracking it a tiny bit. Is I've had a lot of people lately on my YouTube, a lot of you YouTubers of mine, say, Mandy, your hair is like, you're a hairdresser and you don't have trendy hair and it's just long and blonde and blah and not anything to it. Well, I love you all and all the people that have been requesting me to chop my hair off. I hate to break it to you, but I'm staying blonde and I'm staying long. So you can keep saying you need something different and you need something new and you need a new change too. And I'm just a baby when it comes to changes, and I wish I could be like my client Marianne here and just make a change happen. But you know what? This is just who I am. So if you have stuff all over your hands like this, you guys, you make sure you take a towel and you wipe it off, because I'm gonna go in and touch all the blonde, and I don't want this blonde to be colored at all. And it's looking great and it's about ready to wash. I'm mixing up my toner and I'm using Redken Shades EQ Golden Apricot 08WG, and this is going to be just a beautiful golden color. Awesome. So that's 2 ounces. And I'm going to shake it on up and I'm going to show you guys how I'm going to tone the blonde that you guys saw me foil out with conditioner. So you're going to just shake it up really good. This color is pretty much the color that it's going to look on her hair. So it's going to be freaking gorgeous. So I'm going to show you guys how I'm going to tone. This part you have to be super careful. If you have super blonde foils underneath here, you need to take your water and you need to make sure you're washing these out individually, okay? Because you do not want the red tone to bleed onto, okay, sorry, and it might be cool, okay, it's a little bit cold.
That's fine.
Okay, so you're gonna wanna go in here and you're gonna wanna just rinse these all out individually like this. This is gonna be pretty. As you guys can see these little blonde chunks in here, this is too blonde for me. I don't want this to be this blonde. I want it to be more of a beautiful, kind of caramely warm tone. So how I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna take my toner in the bottle, just like this. I'm gonna start from the roots and I'm gonna just go in here and I'm gonna put in, and it's okay if this hits everywhere on the head because it's, the red on here is not gonna make a difference with this. So I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna really make sure I focus really good on the blondes. And toner takes really fast. I already see the color changing. Now this is when I can go in here and just run my fingers through her hair. Because I want it to be a good consistent tone all the way through. Do you guys see how just barely you saw blonde hair and now you're seeing, not blonde anymore, you're seeing this beautiful warm golden, seriously such a pretty tone. I'm gonna give it a good rinse, shampoo, condition, blow it out, and you guys are gonna see the after. You're gonna freak out because it's amazing. I already know it's gonna be amazing. Hello, my little YouTubies. Check out my amazingly gorgeous Marianne redhead. So she's a redhead now. She feels a little bit more frisky. So that's what happens when you are a redhead. Blondes have more fun. Redheads are feisty and frisky and actually very unique and gorgeous. But I just want you guys to see this. Look at her hair. It is absolutely beautiful. And okay, hello, look at her hair. She's a redhead. Look how beautiful this color turned out. Absolutely stunningly gorgeous, beautiful. Super saturated. Look how pretty that tone is. And honestly, I can't tell you enough how much I love it. Don't you even worry. How beautiful is this hair? Like, honestly, this is the thing. This is the place. Utah. Okay. Situation here. Some people are meant to be blonde. Some people are meant to be red. Some people are meant to be brunette. Whatever color you're meant to be, I hope you find it. Because I guess what? We just found it. We just found her color. Do you love it?
I love it. Love it!
So glad.
That
so
awesome.
Yay! And which means that since I'm awesome, you guys, you had to subscribe to my channel. I want you all to learn a good lesson for me, and I hope I'm doing the job for you, but I'm still making like little things alive and fun, you know? So honestly, I love you all, and I love that you're supporting me and you're challenging me and you're telling me what you want to see, because so many people requested, I want to see somebody go from blonde to red. So I showed you guys, and this is what we accomplished, and it's seriously amazing. So if you like it, give me a thumbs up. If you love it enough, share it. And if you want to see me more often, go ahead and hit that little red button, subscribe. Thanks for watching and have a good day. Okay? Bye!
Bye.